Good morning, students, and welcome back to our online class of computer science. Children, in the previous class, I've explained you chapter 1. Even I have shown you some calculations how the various number type, number systems are converted between each others. So today, children, we'll be starting chapter 2. The name of the chapter is Propositional Logic and Hardware. So children, as we know that computer is made up of two different components, hardware and software. Hardware is the part of computer which we can touch, whereas software is a part of computer which we cannot touch. Softwares are the set of programs, instructions. But to let this instruction work, hardware component is required. Maybe you are a good programmer, you wrote the program, but if you don't have a keyboard, can you function and you work? No. That means hardware and software, both coordinations are required. Both are important. So the now concept is how the softwares interact with the hardware. So software gets interacted with hardware with the help of some gets. G-A-T-S, gets. Logic gets. Okay, logic gets. Now logic gate is what? Is the concept of electronics. How the circuits are divided, how the various electronic components are placed on appropriate place, and they do the proper work. So for that some logic gate are there, some standards are there. So in this chapter we are going to learn about this all things. So children, first let me tell you what is propositional logic. The propositional logic represent logic through proposition and logical connectives. We may define proposition as an elementary atomic sentence that may take either true value or false value, but may not take any other value. As we know that computers deal with only binary languages, 0 and 1. So 0 means false, 1 means true. So here proposition means the same thing. When a signal is passed to a hardware component, either it will accept or it will release. So when it is accepting, it is true. When it is releasing, it is false. Okay, so this concept is known as propositions. Okay, now some terms and symbols will be coming on. Propositions can be of simple one and compound one also. Simple proposition is one that does not contain any other proposition as a part. We'll use the lowercase letters, okay, like P, Q, R. For symbols, we'll be using small letters for simple proposition. Compound is one with two or more simple propositions. When two or more simple propositions are mixed up, that is known as compound propositions. For that, we'll take capital letters as a symbols. So now let us come to some connectives. Okay, so before dealing with connectives, what are the connectives? What are the different way of connecting the devices? First, I'll be explaining you logic gates. First, you understand the concept of logic gates. Then only I'll be coming to the part of connectives, how the connections are made. Now, children, so first I'll be coming to the part of logic gates. Now see children, as I have already told you that logic gates or gates simply is a, actually you can say it is the technique or it is a process which allow a hardware device to connect the electronic components. Where, on which positions electronic component will be placed and how they will function, this part, these standards are given by logic gates. Okay, so logic gates is totally dealing with electronic components. So we can say logic gates are actually a type of Boolean algebra. There is some calculations, okay? So we can say logic gets are the type of Boolean algebra. It's a part of Boolean algebra. So logic gates, we have again a different type. So first I'll be coming to the part of basic logic gates. We have three different types. Number one, AND gate. AND gate is symbolized with say D part like this. Okay, and the symbol is plus, sorry, dot, AND gate, dot. So first of all, these gates, how they are made? So they are made with the help of propositions, combinations of various true and false statements. That means combination of various 0 or 1 numbers. So that is known as truth table. So let us take two input, A and B. These are the input. So first of all, always the input start with 0011, then 0101, and let us take the output, that is A dot B, that is the AND gate. So AND gate is like a series gate. If you remember in like class 10, basically in physics, you have learned about series and parallel connections. Okay. So series connections are actually known as AND gate. The series connections are actually known as AND gates. Okay. So in series, the concept was somewhat like this. So this is input, this is output. Now see the condition, if this wire is breaked, do the electricity will pass and reach up to output? No. Same way, if this circuit is, if this resistance is breaked out, condition is same. So to reach input up to output, we need both the circuit, both the signals should be in proper order, both should be on. We can even, we can say that this is a, these are the switches, okay? So switch 1 and switch 2, both switches should be on. If any of the one switch is off, you will not receive any signal. This is the condition for series, or you can say AND gate. So same thing is applied here for truth table also. Off, off, both switch off, output is off. One switch off, another is on. Off, on, off, off, both are on. That means you will receive the output. So students, now this, how the input is translated or converted to output, the concept I think you understood, isn't it? The concept you can take from here, series part, switch 1, switch 2. If both switches are on, then only you receive the output. If any of the one switch is off, you won't receive the output. Now children, the same, this technique physically is implemented in hardware devices. How? With the help of circuit diagram. There is circuit diagram. Now circuit diagram is like this. A and B are the two input. We'll use the symbols A dot B, and this is the part where we place electronic device or component. You can see any electronic gadget, they have one board known as motherboard. Maybe mobile phones, maybe a remote, maybe computer, laptop, any electronic gadgets. That board backside, if you see, you'll find some circuits, some wires. They're fiber optics wire. They are placed. And like this part is there. And here you may see a capacitor, you may see diode, you may see transistors. Okay, electronic components, they are placed. So these electronic components, where they should be placed in a proper order, okay, so that the signal should flow as per as the instruction given, that is decided by the gates. And there are basically three basic gates Okay, basic guess means without that further processing is not possible at all. Among that basic get, one important is AND get, which we follow as a series combinations, series connections. For series connection, the logic is very simple. If all the connections are on, then only you receive the output. If any of the connection is off, if any of the switch is off, or if any of the wire is breakdown, you won't receive the signal. So children, this part you understood. Now let us move to another part. So we understood the first basic gates, that is AND gate. Now let us move to second part, that is the OR gate. OR. Some symbols are like you'll get the arrow type and indicated by plus. It's a parallel one, like if this is the input, this is output. Let us consider this one, switch 1, switch 2. Now if you write the truth table, we'll take the two value, say A, B, 00, 11. Concept is same, A plus B. Now let us follow the rule of parallel connections. So for parallel connection, what is the rule? For parallel connection, the rule is we have to make any of the switches on. Any of the switches on. Okay, either switch 1 you can make it on, or you can make it switch 2 on, or you can make both the switch on. If any of the switch is on, you will receive the signals. Okay, these are parallel connections. Any one switch is on, you receive. If both switches on, definitely you receive. But if both switches are off, you won't receive any signal. If both switches are off, you won't receive any signal, any output. This is the concept. This is the conditions. In case of parallel, if any one of the switch is on, you will receive the output. And only in one case you won't receive the output, that is if both the switches are off. That time you won't receive. So based on this logic, this parallel concept logic, let us write the output part here. So 00 means both off, no signals. 01 means see, one is on, another is off, so receive signal. Here also receive signal, and both are on, receive signals. So based on this, we have a circuit. Based on this, we have a circuit diagram, or we can say logic circuit diagram. So this circuit diagrams, again, the concept is that how the wires are placed in a board so that the electronic component will be placed in a proper order if you are following a parallel connections. So option is there. Okay, we can follow either parallel connections or we can follow the series connection. Based on our requirement, based on the device requirement, we use this sort of connections. Computers support both. Some computers, some laptops, some gadget, they have parallel, some they have series. So now see, for circuit diagrams, okay, this one, we have two inputs, let us say A and B, A plus B. So this is the logic circuit diagram for OR gate. OR gate is the connection, okay, which follow parallel parallel connections, whereas AND gate follow series connections. So children, the difference between parallel and series means AND gate and OR gate is what? In AND gate, to receive the signals, only one condition is there. That is both the connection, if we are taking with two input. We can work with two input, three input and four input. Maximum we can work is with four input. You might have seen the wall sockets, okay? You have the 2-pin, 3-pin, and nowadays some heavy devices comes with 4-pin. That's the maximum one. And the connections, the logic, connectives will be this part, either AND or part. So AND means we are following the series connections, OR means we are following the parallel connections. But children, there are some components which doesn't follow, neither they follow this one or nor they follow AND. They are just opposite, different type component. You might have heard the name of inverter. So inverter is what? The separate type of connections. Inverter circuit you won't get as like this one, what we call like parallel or series, AND or you won't get. So that inverter concept we're using in laptops, we're using in UPS. So we can say laptop battery is what? Inverter concepts. UPS is what? Inverter concept. Inverter is also a type of kit which a gadget require. So let us see how inverter works. Okay. So we'll move toward inverter type. That means the third basic type of logic gate. That is, we say NOT gate, or even it is a inverter. Okay. The logic circuit diagram is like this. These are symbols. Okay. And it is indicated by either bar, tilde, or you can say single inverted comma. So any of the one we can use for symbols, for inverter, for NOT gate. So children, we learn about parallel connection, we learn about series connection, that is AND gate and OR gate. Now the third basic type is NOT gate. Now see here, you might have seen here, in OR and AND I have used two lines, okay, for input, because there we have the 2-pin socket, 3-pin socket and 4-pin socket. But inverter, you have only a single pin socket. Inverter, you cannot use 2-pin, 3-pin, 4-pin. Not possible. Reason behind, when electricity is there, inverter off. When electricity goes off, inverter on. Opposite. When signal comes, it will stop its work. When signal doesn't come, it will release its work. That is inverter. So this is the concept of NOT gate. So this concept we are using for designing the truth table. See here. Truth tables. So we have a single part, like only one input you get, 0, 1. So either off or on. So you can use bar, tilde, or single inverted comma. So now children, when we doesn't receive the signals, then when in input case no signal, that time in case of output we receive the signal. One. Just opposite. Same way, when in the input we receive the signal, output will stop without signals. Zero. That's why it is called inverter or NOT gate. When electricity is there, device stops. Okay. When electricity stops, device active. So now children, based on this, we have circuit diagram, okay, logic circuit diagrams. So we have single input. So this symbols is actually indicating NOT, this the circle part, and the output we get is the bar, A bar or A tilde, okay, tilde, bar or single inverted comma, any of the one symbols we can use to represent NOT gate. So children, today we'll be discussing only the basic gates. So there are three different types of basic gates. That means without this basic gate, there is not at all possible to place any electronic devices, any electronic components to create any gadget. In fact, computer is also a gadget which has a hardware as well as software. So hardware concept when comes, that means there is some electronic component. There are diode, transistors, IC, okay, these are some electronic components which are placed. You can see there is a motherboard in computer also, and if you see the backside, you will find the circuit design, and that circuit designs are actually done by the help of this logic gates. So computers support both AND as well as OR. Okay, that's why you will find some computer supports a series connection, some parallel connections, some with a very low voltage also it will work, some require a high voltage, low voltage it will not work. So these things, these changes, this variation we see, this is all because of their logic gate design, their circuit designs. Okay, and NOT concept is also used in computer, because computer has UPS. And forget about computer, laptop also, we can say laptop, tab, mobile phone, that is smartphones. So they follow the NOT concept also, NOT gate concept also. Okay, so there are total three different types of gates. Now see, as technologies are advancing, we need more like powerful gadgets. So this basic gate was not sufficient. Some more additional gates was added, which we'll discuss in our next class. So try to understand this concept. Okay, what is propositions, what is logic gates, basically the basic one, and or and not, how the truth tables are made, how the logic circuit diagram are designed. Clear, children?